For this is the recommended hours of sleep one should get by age from the National Sleep Foundation. For example, if you are 18 to 64 years old, you most likely will need 7 to 9 hours of sleep. Are you struggling to hit that mark? There are several things that could be sabotaging your sleep. First, your sleep schedule.
That the more time you spend in bed, the more your sleep starts to fragment and pull apart, and then people end up spending 10 hours in bed, but they're up and down all night long.
When you are in bed and you are wide awake, get out of bed. The bed should only be used for sleeping, not eating, not watching TV, not scrolling through your Facebook feed. If you're a late nighter, early riser during the week, don't bank on catching up on sleep over the weekend.
During the week, you're getting up too early, and the weekend, you're sleeping in too late, and so you're always going to feel off a little bit. What ends up is that people end up sleeping 10 hours or 12 hours to catch up, and then the next day, they only sleep 5 or 6, and it ends up with this like total yo-yo thing that's happening. There's a name for that called social jet lag.
Keep your sleep schedule consistent all week long, including weekends, and be sure to wind down as you get closer to bedtime. Log off the computer, switch off bright lights, lay off caffeine, and skip the nightcap. That's the second thing sabotaging sleep. Alcohol. That's right. Don't have that "the kids are finally asleep" glass of wine.
It helps to fall asleep more quickly. Unfortunately, the whole consequence of that is that although they may fall asleep quickly, the rest of the night is more likely to be disturbed.
And alcohol actually makes sleep problems like sleep apnea worse. So that one is easy. Drink less alcohol and don't drink it before bed. The third thing sabotaging sleep, and you know you do this, you worry so much about your sleep that you can't sleep.
A person may start to really dread getting into bed in the first place because they're anticipating having difficulties, being frustrated with sleep, and of course that can become a self-fulfilling prophecy.
If you're stressed about sleeping and you're trying to sleep, that makes it worse because the moment you want it is the time that you can't get it.
So don't just lay in bed and worry. Get up. Go somewhere else. Do something quiet and relaxing. Meditation actually helps. You also need to work on retraining your thought process. When something negative pops into your head, fight it off by challenging that negative thought.
Our brain and our mind may automatically make some assumptions and some thoughts that aren't very productive or helpful.
Practice challenging negative thoughts, and eventually it'll become second nature, and you'll scare off worry before it has a chance to snowball. Fourth, those electronics. The light delays sleep. Give yourself a cutoff time from the phone or tablet, at least an hour or two before bedtime. Charge it in another room to help decrease the temptation to look just one more time. And fifth, lack of exercise.
I mean, people, when they're not sleeping well, they feel fatigued, they don't feel like exercising, but that's really one of the best things that people can do for their sleep.
What if you check all those boxes? For the most part, you do have a consistent bedtime. You don't drink, you fight off worry, and you exercise, and you still can't sleep. You may have chronic insomnia.
1 in 10 people have chronic insomnia, and that's difficulty falling asleep, staying asleep, waking up too early.